case, the other student closed her case, but Yolanda has not been given an opportunity to tell her side of the story. But yet the proctor found her guilty, based only on the university's version. I've already done a procedural irregularity on the part of disciplinary hearing. And Yolanda would have been able to challenge this, not only in the High Court, but in the internal review process of the university, right? She was then denied that opportunity when we went to launch the internal review. Yesterday, we sent them the internal review again and said, you have now said publicly you will consider this review. Please then tell us, you know, tell us what are the next steps, right? Because we are then assuming they maybe realize their mistake and they will consider the review. Our experience of roads, right? They might just write back to us and say, we are not considering it. I mean, the craziest thing was that all the communication was coming from the prosecutor, right? So the prosecutor was standing as a prosecutor and a judge at the same time, and the university was allowing that, right? Which already tells you that there's a problem. You can't be a participant and a judge at the same time. Mm-hmm. But so that would be one of the ways that we would seek to review the proceedings. We are, even now, in the internal review, we have raised the issue of bias. That from the beginning of the hearing, the proctor was biased against Yolanda and came out and said, in the High Court papers, this one was found, but asking, but those papers are not properly in front of you. No one, the disciplinary hearing hasn't even started, right? Three, another ground, and I think Musi just spoke to it now, is that the university is charging of having committed a criminal offense, right? But that they are doing that, and they are concluding, and the owners, they use the balance of probabilities. But they want them labeled them as criminals on a balance of probabilities. And even when the disciplinary hearing began, we said, we raised the point of limit, saying you cannot, as the university, find them guilty of a criminal offense. A court must do that. You can discipline them for misconduct, but you can't find them guilty of a criminal offense as the university. And maybe if you must, you must at the very least then apply the very standard of proof. And in fact, our courts have said this in relation to contempt proceedings, to say, if you're going to charge someone with contempt of court, you must use the balance of probabilities as the level. Mm-hmm. The fact that, again, they refuse to give the internal review, if they confirm that refusal, so you give them an opportunity now again to say, are you confirming your refusal? You know, or are you looking to consider the review? So they might say, actually, we are considering, then it might have a different result. We do not know. That's where things are now. We are currently in the process of preparing the High Court review. Our plan is to make sure that it is served before the end of January. And that's where things are, because we need to transcribe the recordings of the hearings. I need to make sure that we have all the papers, because the High Court would have to have regard to all the papers that were exchanged and all the evidence that was exchanged in the disciplinary hearing. Did I cover it?
So for any further questions, please do direct them at the end of the press briefing to Nomzamo, Seri, or Yolanda. On behalf of